Hello guys, welcome to another wonderful session of Learning with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, we are going to be solving Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 3 from question 26 to question 30. Subscribe to our channel, like and comment on our videos as I will be happy to respond to your comments in the comment section. Alright, you can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Without further ado, let's move on to the first question in this video. 26. Evaluate 829,934.478 correct to three significant figures. Oh, this is interesting. So, what are significant figures? That is what you need to know first for you to be able to answer this question. Significant figures are the digits that have meaning or contribute to the value of a number. Okay. To correct a number to a particular significant figure, all you have to do is to draw a vertical line after the desired significant figures. Okay, so here we are asked to correct it to three significant figures. So we have to draw a vertical line after the third digit. So this is it here. 829 is the first three digits. So we put a vertical line after 829. Okay, then look at the next digit. If the next digit is 4 or less, that is 4, 3, 2, 1, or 0, keep the previous digit as it is. But if the next digit is 5 or more, that is 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, increase the previous digit by 1. Now, what's the next digit after 829? That is 9. So 9 is 5 or more, right? Okay, so what do? We increase the previous digit by 1. So if we add 1 to 9, it becomes 10. So we write 0 and add the 1 to 2 and this becomes 3. So now it is now 830. Then you leave all the other numbers as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so you replace all the remaining numbers with 0. So you have 830, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 829,934.478 is now 830,000.000. We can remove the decimal there since it doesn't really have any meaning. Okay, so it becomes 830,000. So 829,934.478 correct to three significant figures is 830,000. So which of the option is correct? B is the correct option, 830,000. Question 27. Divide 25,420.15 by 413. Okay, so for us to divide these numbers, we have to use the method called long division method. Long division method is used to divide large numbers into groups. So it is used to divide very large numbers. It helps in breaking the division problem into a sequence of steps. So let's see how it is being done here. So 25,420.15 divided by 413. So the first thing is to find the first possible digit that is divisible by 413. So 2542 is divisible by 413. 2542 divided by 413 is 6. 6 times 413 is 2478. Now let's subtract 2478 from 2542. 2 minus 8 is not possible, so we get 1 from 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. Then we put the 1 here, it becomes 12. 12 minus 8 is 4. 3 minus 7 is not possible, so we get 1 from the previous digit, which is 5. Then it remains 4 now. Then put the 1 here, this becomes 13. 13 minus 7 is 6. 4 minus 4 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. So the answer is 64. 64 is not divisible by 413, so we have to bring down the next digit, which is 0. So we now have 640 now. 640 divided by 413 is 1. 1 times 413 is 413. So let's subtract 413 from 640. 0 minus 3 is not possible, so we have to get one from 4. 4 minus 1 is 3, then we put the 1 here, this becomes 10. 10 minus 3 is 7, then 3 minus 1 is 2, 6 minus 4 is 2. So we now have 227. 227 is not divisible by 413. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 1. But before we bring down the next digit, can you see that there is a decimal point here? So we put the decimal point here also. Okay, before we continue. So now let's bring down the next digit, which is 1 now. So we have 2271. 2271 divided by 413 is 5. So 5 times 413 is 2065. So let's subtract 2065 from 2271. 1 minus 5 is not possible, so we get 1 from 7. And then 7 minus 1 is 6. We put the 1 here, this becomes 11. 11 minus 5 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. So now we have 206. 206 is not divisible by 413. So we have to bring down the last digit here, which is 5. So now we have 2065 divided by 413, which will give us 5. 5 multiplied by 413 is 2065. 2065 minus 2065 is 0. So now we've been able to completely divide 25,420.15 by 413. So the answer is 61.55. So which of the options is correct? Option C is the correct option. 61.55. Check. Now let's move on to the next question. Evaluate 9,322.89 minus 9,048.6. So these are decimal numbers and we are asked to subtract them. Okay. The first thing you need to do is to write down the numbers and line up the decimal points on top of each other. Can you see here? Decimal points are on top of each other. So we have done that. Then the next thing is to check if they are like decimals. Like decimals are decimals that have the same number of decimal places. So the number of decimal places is determined by the number of digits after the decimal point. So this first decimal, 9,322.89, has two decimal places because there are two digits after the decimal point. 9,048.6 has just one decimal place because there is only one digit after the decimal point. So now this means that they are not like decimals. So we need to convert them to like decimals. So we can add 0 to 9,048.6. So now it now has two decimal places. So they both have two decimal places now. So they are like decimals. So we can subtract now. 9 minus 0 is 9. 8 minus 6 is 2. 2 minus 8 is not possible. So we get 1 from 2. And then this remains 1. When we put that 1 here, it becomes 12. 12 minus 8 is 4. 1 minus 4 is not possible. So we get 1 from 3. And 3 remains 2. Then we put that 1 here and this becomes 11. 11 minus 4 is 7. 2 minus 0 is 2. So now 9,322.89 minus 9,048.6 is 274.29. So you can see that subtraction of decimal numbers are actually very easy. Okay, so the correct option is C, 274.29. Number 29, divide 774,039 by 899. Okay, so this is similar to question 27. So we are also going to be using the long division method for this. Okay, so let's start. I hope you still remember the steps. The first thing is to find out the first possible digit that is divisible by 899. So the first possible digit is 7,740. 7,740 divided by 899 is 8. 8 times 899 is 7,192. Now let's subtract 7,192 from 7,740. 0 minus 2 is not possible. So we get 1 from 4 and this remains 3. Let's put the 1 here, this becomes 10. 10 minus 2 is 8. 3 minus 9 is not possible. So we get 1 from 7, and this remains 6. And then we put the 1 here, it becomes 13. 13 minus 9 is 4. Then 6 minus 1 is 5. 7 minus 7 is 0, so we don't write it. So now we have 548. And this is not divisible by 899. So we have to drop down the next digit, which is 3. So we now have 5483. 5483 divided by 899 is 6. 6 times 899 is 5394. Now let's subtract 5394 from 5483. 3 minus 4 is not possible. So we get 1 from 8 and it remains 7. And then this becomes 13. 13 minus 4 is 9. Then 7 minus 9 is not possible. So we have to get 1 from 4 and it remains 3. We put the 1 here, it becomes 17. 17 minus 9 is 8. 3 minus 3 is 0. 5 minus 5 is 0. So now we have 89. 89 is not divisible by 899. So we have to drop the last digit, which is 9. So we now have 899. 899 divided by 899 is 1. 1 times 899 is 899. So let's subtract 899 from 899. We'll get 0. So now we've been able to completely divide 774,039 by 899. And the answer is 861. So the correct option here is C. 861. Check. Question 30. 28 laborers can finish a piece of work in 228 days. How many days will it take 38 laborers to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? So this question is very interesting. So 28 laborers can finish a piece of work in 228 days. So how many days will it take 38 laborers to complete the same work if they work at the same rate? Of course, it will take them less days to complete the work, because the higher the number of laborers, the lower the number of days. So the number of laborers is inversely proportional to the number of days. So this means that when the number of laborers increase, the number of days to finish the work will decrease. Okay, since they now work at the same rate, we can use the formula T equals K over N to find the rate at which they are working. Okay, so T is time, K is constant of proportionality, which is also the rate. Then N is number of laborers. So the first part of the question says 28 laborers finish a piece of work in 228 days. So now we want to find out the rate at which they are working to be able to find out the second part. So the time is 228 days, and then the number is 28 laborers. So T equals K over N. T is 228 equals, K is unknown, the rate is unknown, that's what we want to find, divided by the number of laborers, which is 28. So now let's cross multiply, and we're going to have K equals 228 multiplied by 28, and we can do that here. 8 times 8 is 64, so write 4, carry 6. 8 times 2 is 16, 16 plus 6 is 22, so write 2, carry 2. 8 times 2 is 16, 16 plus 2 is 18. So 2 times 8 is 16, write 6, carry 1. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. 2 times 2 is 4, so you write it here. And now let's add. 4 plus nothing is 4. 2 plus 6 is 8. 8 plus 5 is 13. Write 3, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 4 is 6. So now the product of 228 and 28 is 6384. So the rate at which they are working is 6384. So this would enable us to find how many days it will take 38 laborers to complete the same work at the same rate, because now we have found the rate at which they are working. So now we need to find the time. So the rate is 6384. Then the number of laborers now is 38. Now we are asked to find the time. How many days will it take them to finish the same piece of job at the same rate? So we have T equals 6384 divided by 38. Now let's do that here. So we have 6384 divided by 38. The first possible digit divisible by 38 is 63. 63 divided by 38 is 1. 1 multiplied by 38 is 38. Then let's subtract 38 from 63. 3 minus 8 is not possible. So we get 1 from 6, and then this becomes 5. And then this is now 13. 13 minus 8 is 5. 5 minus 3 is 2. So now we have 25. 25 is not divisible by 38. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 8. So we now have 258. 258 divided by 38 will give us 6. 6 multiplied by 38 is 228. Now let's subtract 228 from 258. 8 minus 8 is 0. 5 minus 2 is 3. 2 minus 2 is 0. So we don't write it. So now we have 30. 30 is less than 38, so it's not divisible by 38. So we have to bring down the next digit, which is 4. So we now have 304. 304 divided by 38 is 8. 8 multiplied by 38 is 304. So 304 minus 304 is 0. So we've been able to completely divide 6384 by 38. And that gives us 168. So this means that it will take the 38 laborers 168 days to complete the same work if they work at the same rate. Okay, so that's the answer, 168 days. So which of the options is correct? A is 188 days, B is 168 days, C is 783 days, D is 838 days. So the correct option is B, 168 days. Check. I hope you've been able to learn a lot from this video. Please don't forget to like and comment on our video. And also, subscribe to this channel so that you can get more videos like this. Then you can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time, bye for now.